In this lecture, we will look at the points related to general features or salient features of the genetic code. This is again a question that may be asked in a 7 mark or 10 marks there in the semester examination. So the genetic code is triplet in nature and it codes for codon. So you already know what is mean by a codon. Codon is the one which is made up of triplet, that is 3 nucleotides should be present there among the 4, that is A, U, G, C. So the explanation has been provided there, but if you remember this point, it will be enough. That is a salient point there. Then the second point is the code is unambiguous in nature. It's meaning that each triplet will specify only for a single amino acid. None of the triplet can able to specify 2 different kinds of amino acid. The next point is the code contains the start as well as stop signal. That is, certain triplets that are necessary to initiate and terminate the translation process were also arranged there in the list of codons. So out of 64 codons, 3 codons that will be coding as a stop codons, especially UAA, UAG and UGA, they are referred as a stop codons. As we already discussed in another video, the start codon is actually AUG, that in turn codes for amino acid methionine or formyl methionine. The next point is no internal punctuation, that is comma will be commonly used in the code. That is meaning code is said to be comma-less component. Once the translation of mRNA begins there, that is in the site of the ribosomes, the codons of the mRNA are read one after another with no breaks that have been present in between them. So they will be read continuously during the process of protein synthesis. The next point is code is said to be degenerate, meaning that a given amino acid can be specified by more than one triplet kind of a code. Such kind of synonymous codon or redundant codons are present mainly to minimize the effects of the mutation. So this case applies best for the 18 of the 20 amino acids. So the different codons for a given amino acid are said to be synonymous or redundant in nature. For example, UUU and UUC are synonymous codon that codes for an amino acid phenylalanine. Whereas serine is the one which is encoded by more than 5 different kinds of codons. That is, serine is encoded by synonymous codons UCU, UCC, UCA, UCG, AGU and AGC. So this can be best understandable when you are looking into this particular table. So you can able to see the serine codons are all arranged here as well as it has been arranged in the last quarter here. So here is a list of amino acids and their synonymous codons. Say for example, leucine, serine, arginine are coded by more than 5 codons. That is 6 synonymous codons are involved in coding this amino acid. Whereas glycine, proline, alanine, valine and threonine are coded by 4 synonymous codons. Isoleucine is coded by 3 synonymous codons. Whereas the phenylalanine, tyrosine, cysteine, histidine, glutamine, glutamic acid, aspartic acid, aspargine and lysine are coded by 2 synonymous codons. Methionine and tryptophan are coded by a single codon. These things could be best visualized when you are looking into this genetic code table. Now we look at some more points related to the synonymous codon. The synonymous codons are not positioned randomly but are grouped in the table. Generally they differ only in the third position. That is, the third nucleotide alone will be having a change there in the synonymous codons. Say for example, you look at the synonymous codons of the serine. So these 4 are the synonymous codons of the serine in which only the third nucleotide is having a change. Whereas the other 2 nucleotides are commonly made up of U and C. So in all cases, if the third position is a pyrimidine or a purine, then the codons specify same, that is synonymous kind of amino acid, that is same amino acid will be specified by those codons. If the second position is a pyrimidine, then generally the amino acid specified is of a hydrophilic in nature. So in order to understand this point, we need to understand what are all the group of hydrophilic amino acids. So here in the list of hydrophilic amino acids, that is glycine, serine, tyrosine, glutamine and lysine and aspartic acid. Now we look at the case what we have discussed with serine. Look at here the synonymous codons of the serine. In the second position, what that has been present is actually a pyrimidine and not a purine. Whereas if the second position is of a purine, then the type of amino acid specified will be polar in nature. The next point is concerned with the nature of the code. That is, the genetic code is non-overlapping nature. That is, at the time of translation process, the genetic code will be read as a non-overlapping code. The next point is related to the universality of the genetic code. That is, we have already read about this detail in the previous video. That is, the genetic code is nearly universal. However, it is not universally operating in all the living organisms. There is certain small changes that have been present there in the living organism. For that, we have seen a lot of examples there in the previous video also. Here also, a few points have been highlighted there. Say, for example, UGA is the one which codes for stop codon universally in all living organisms, whereas it codes for tryptophan in mycoplasma, spiroplasma, and mitochondria of several species. And then the other two stop codon, that is UAA, UAG, acts as a stop codon universally, whereas it codes for glutamine in Acetabularia, Tetrahymenia, and Paramecium. That is, certain unicellular organisms found to have the UAA, UAG stop codon as a glutamine coding codon during the process of the translation. The last and final point related to the salient features of the genetic code is, the genetic codes are commonly present as an open reading frame. That is, they seems to exist in open reading frame, which refers to any segment of a gene that found to possess a start codon. That is, AUG is the one which serves as a start codon, which codes for N-formyl methionine. That is the first amino acid to be added during the translation process, followed by few codon, which further finally ends up with a stop codon, which should be basically of a UAA, UAG or UGA. When such kind of arrangement is there, then the particular segment alone is translated specifically into a protein molecule.